Hello and welcome to the video series Runtime Analysis in AUTOSAR Embedded Projects. My name is Florian Sommer and I'm responsible for the business development for the product line Embedded Software at Vector Informatik in Stuttgart. In this video, I'm going to show you more about the different details levels you can reach with scheduling traces. So let's have a look at the scheduling trace that you have already seen in the last video where I introduced this kind of analysis technique. You can here see that we have recorded the state transitions of one task. So you can see here with the dark green, whenever a task is running actively on the core, the little arrows here before this green color always indicate that the task was activated. And once it's white, then the task is terminated and not running anymore. With the green color here, it is indicated that this task was preempted. So that at this point in time, another task with a higher priority was running on this core. And now we are going to move to the next level of detail. So now we have only recorded one of the tasks. And we can see that here this task is getting preempted basically all the time when it is running. When it's activated, it starts running, but it always gets preempted. So now, of course, you want to analyze what is happening and which other task is interfering with your task here. And here in the next picture, now you're able to see that we have not only recorded this one task, but we have recorded additionally other tasks that are running inside this ECU. You can see on the left side the different cores that this system has. So we have two cores, core 1 and core 2. And you can see all the tasks and you can see all the activations and terminations as well as preemptions. What you can see additionally here in this picture now is that some tasks don't only have preemptions, but some of the tasks are getting activated and it takes quite some time until they are starting to actively run on the core. This is indicated by this gray color. And what you can see now, if you have a look at this task, for example, you can see that it is running on core 1. And then that at the point in time where this task is getting activated, another task, which seems to have a higher priority, is already running on this core. So this task is getting to run only after the task 1 millisecond is terminated. That's what you can see here. And as well for the task that we had initially analyzed, so this task 2 millisecond on the button, what you can see here is also that the preemptions that we can see with the light green color have been caused by other tasks that were running with a higher priority on this core 2. For example, here it is getting preempted and starts to run again after the task writing actuator stopped running on this core. Now, as a next level of detail, you might not only be interested in the general task run times, but you might also want to see here for the task 2 milliseconds, which runnable was running at this point in time and which runnable was preempted. And what you can do here, if you additionally use not only the OS hooks that are used for the tasks, but if you also additionally instrument the VFB hooks in the DaVinci configurator, you will be able to get a picture that looks like this. And what you can see here now with the blue color, you can see additionally the different runnables that are running inside this task. And you can now additionally see which of the runnables was executed in which order, first of all, inside the task. And you can now also see which of the runnables was preempted while your task is getting preempted. Since it's a little bit hard to follow who is preempting whom in this picture, you can also run interference analysis. And if you do that, you will get a picture like this. Now you can see that we have these red lines in the same picture as before. And these red lines are now indicating whenever a task is interfering with another one. So if we take this example of this task input processing that has been activated but was not running for quite some time on the core, you can see that the interference with this task was caused by this task 1 millisecond up there. The same is true for the task 2 milliseconds that we have been looking at from the beginning. And you can see every time where you have a preemption, you see an interference line to the task that has been interacting with it. And this is very helpful if you want to analyze such a system, because it allows you to visually see who is interrupting whom. So you can draw back conclusions to change your priorities of your tasks, for example, or think about other solutions like aligning the offset if they are activated at the same point in time, or maybe putting a task to a different core in case it's always the same task that is interfering with another task. That's all on the detail levels for now. In the upcoming videos, we're going to have a closer look at the automatization of this kind of analysis. At the end of this video, I want to offer you some possibilities to stay in touch and find out more about timing analysis. For that, I'm inviting you to join the LinkedIn group Runtime Analysis in AUTOSAR Projects. In this group, you will meet other people working in this field, sharing their experiences and solutions for this topic. And you will, of course, also be able to engage in discussions and ask your questions there. Just search for the group directly on LinkedIn. Or if you want to have it easier, I put a QR code here in the video so you can simply scan the QR code and you will be redirected to this group. Would be happy to have you in the group. If you have questions to me directly, or if you want to connect with me, I'm inviting you to scan the QR code here on the right. You can also see the link to my profile here on LinkedIn. I would be very happy to connect with you and answer any questions you have. Thank you very much for watching this video. I'm looking forward to stay in touch with you.